Okay, you're getting ready to start with a parallel break shot. Let's see how you control your cue ball here. Nice shot, but you see how your cue ball is getting beat up as you're going forward? You get a pretty good result. Your cue ball is kind of in the middle of the stack there. Let's go ahead and look at what you have and what you don't have. The first thing I notice, you have a good cue ball break ball combination right there with those two stripe balls. And you know, you got a nice setup shot, a key to the key to get on that. You need to start by pocketing the three into that corner pocket and getting rid of those two balls, which are behind the break ball. And once you do that, it should be pretty smooth sailing. And I'm not sure if you started out with that in mind, because you start out with the three ball here and you just start shooting balls in between the, I guess that's the two ball and the eight ball. And you go over to that side rail. And as you start clearing these balls out, I believe that you saw what I saw and that you wanted to go ahead and save those two balls, or actually those three balls, for your end pattern. And then all of a sudden you just started shooting balls in between the two and the eight here. So there you go. And I really believe you need to get in there to knock the both of those balls to clear out that pocket, because some of the balls don't go along that rail. So you come up there, you knock the two, and you come back down past the side pocket. So you kind of let go of your cue ball there a little bit, and the only reason you should be down on that end of the table is to take care of those three balls down there. But you notice the problem with the eight in front of that pocket, so you go ahead and you shoot it off. Now right here you should go for that yellow ball, that one ball, and you're kind of on the 50-yard line. You don't know whether to shoot that or to shoot this 14. I believe that's either the 14 or the 10, really can't tell. But you go ahead and you shoot it off. So now you've got the five ball, and the only key balls that I see are the ball that you're getting ready to shoot right now, in between the five and the one. That's a key ball, and then you have that stripe ball, which is right down there, the one you're getting ready to shoot off here. Bang. See, now you really don't have a key ball to get on the five as a break ball, unless you try to leave one of those balls that are over on the other side of the table and try to set up for a shot. But you've kind of trapped yourself into shooting them off. And this is where I think you realize that you're in trouble. You go and you pocket that ball, and let's go ahead and look at what you have here. Now, it's not as bad as you thought it was. I mean, you've got that ball there that's behind the five. And you've got that ball there. Neither one of them are good key balls at all. And the reason is because they're behind the break ball. You really don't want to have anything that's behind a break ball, because you're gonna run into it. You run the risk of getting the wrong angle or moving it and not having any shot at all. So what you should do is pocket that ball and just abandon the five. You know, shoot the one ball in, get on the five, pocket it in the side to get a shot on that ball there. I believe it's a 10 ball, and use that as your break ball. I guess you thought it was too low, or you didn't see that. Nonetheless, this kind of works out for you. It's not the kind of end pattern that I would recommend, because it's kind of dangerous. Right now, you're going to shoot this ball off. You run the risk of crashing into the yellow ball there. You just missed it. And you come back over, and your tangent line is going right into that five ball. So you have to really, really be careful here. And you do a good job of pocketing this and getting on the break ball. See, that's nicely done. There. Yeah, how you doing? Nice haircut. So anyway, you're on a run of 14 balls. Pretty good rack. Like I've said to you before, you're not going to miss any shots. I've already noticed that about you. If you're going to miss a shot, it's going to be a bank shot, or it's going to be a kick or something like that. You've really got your aiming down, and when you fire a ball in, you really have it down pat to where you know it's going to go right into center pocket. So Ron Vitello and Hal Hull have done a really good job schooling you. And let's not forget the liquid courage. There we go. That's the stuff that makes Spider Dave fly. And what I want you to watch here is watch what your cue ball does on this break shot. You've got a nice shot to get in there. This ball is a little bit closer to the rack, and it reminds me of the first evaluation that I did to you, the break ball that you gave up, than the 13. But watch your cue ball. See how it came back over and into there? You want to get your cue ball to the center of the table. So right now you've got three balls that are back there in the kitchen area. It looks like you've got some break ball options here. It's a little bit too early to tell. If you want to spread some more of the balls out, you could use this ball that's on the rail to go back up into the balls. I think that's the 10 ball that's up on the left-hand side above the rack area. That looks to be a pretty good break ball. There's no cue balls, anything in your key, what I call the cue ball area. So right now you're doing a really good job of clearing out these corner pockets. And see that there, I really didn't understand why you thought you had to go back into the balls, but it worked out for you. You were able to nudge that ball out as a break ball. And here, what I like about what you're doing here is you're looking at it from all angles. You're stopping, you're taking your time. You're really making sure what sequence that you're going to have. And the only flaw that I'm seeing is basically in your break shots. You're really not getting any balls that come out to the center of the table.